Hello everyone and welcome to the workshop. My name is Faisal Jahangiri. I'm Vice President of Clinical Affairs at Access Neuromonitoring. And today we are going to talk about train of four, how to do the train of four, what is the importance, and how to do the setup. Train of four is very important. In every cases where you are doing EMG and motor evoked potential recording, and it's very important to know how to set up for the train of four and how to set up the programming for train of four. So let's talk about how to set up the train of four. The train of four, when the anesthesiologist give a muscle laxative to the patient, the muscle laxative affects your face, then upper extremity, and then the lower extremity. And the reason is the blood supply. The face has a more blood supply, more vascular compared to upper extremity and lower extremity. And when the drug is stopped, it starts reversing, and the reversal is again, the face is reversed before the hand and the feet. So the face is the first one to have four twitches, the hand followed by upper extremity and the lower extremity. And the reason is the venous drainage. The face has more venous drainage compared to the feet muscle. So every time you are doing EMG or motor evoked potential recording from lower extremity, you have to make sure you are doing the recording from the most distal side. So we always recommend to do train of four from your foot muscle because the foot one is the last one to recover. And if the foot is recovered, that means all the muscles are recovered. Let's do the setup. So in order to do the setup, you have to stimulate posterior tibial nerve in lower extremity and record from the foot muscle. You can also stimulate the peroneal nerve at the knee and record from tibialis anterior muscle. But let's do the posterior tibial at the ankle. So we place the distal electrode, which is a cathode, and the proximal electrode next to medial malleolus, and have to do on bilaterally because if you have issue on the left side, you can do on the right side. You have to make sure you're doing surface electrode. Surface electrode are sticky, they have less current density, and they have much better responses. If the patient has edema or has swelling or cast or some issues with the feet, you can use alternately needle electrode for stimulation. But initially it's better to use the sticky electrode. For recording, we place the electrode in the feet for abductor hallucis muscle and extensor hallucis longus muscle for recording train of four muscle. So for the setup, the cathode should always be more distal. For the programming, we always make sure that the programming is set up to the international system. And what is that is a pulse width of 200 microseconds, 2 hertz frequency for 2 seconds, total number of 4 seconds, 4 twitches or stimulation. And the time base should be 20 milliseconds per division. If it is 2 milliseconds per division, all the twitches will be overlapping and you will not be able to identify the difference. So make sure the sweep is set to 20 milliseconds per division. The current stimulation, you can start from a few milliseconds and can go up to 100 milliseconds. But the threshold of a normal nerve is about 2 to 3 milliseconds. So if you have to go higher to 50, 60, or 100 milliampere to get a response, that means something is wrong or patient has muscle relaxation. Ideally, you should have somewhere between 15 to 25 milliampere current for all four twitches. And in order to identify or record as a full twitch, you should have the fourth twitch as with a minimum fade, and that's about 30% maximum. So 10% is ideal, but 30% fade is okay up to fourth twitch to count as a full twitch. So if you have 4 out of 4 twitches present, that means you have either 0 or maximum 5% paralysis, because sometimes the anesthetic agent has some paralytic effect. If you have 3 out of 4 twitches, that means you have 65 to 75% muscle paralyzed. If you have 2 out of 4 twitches, you have 85% muscles are paralyzed. And if you have 1 twitch, 95% muscles are paralyzed. And at 0 twitch, you have 100% muscle paralyzed. So in order to do a good monitoring, and you need to have all 4 twitches present. So having a 2 twitches or 3 twitches is not recommended, because that means you have 75 to 85% muscle paralyzed and you cannot do an optimal recording. So always make sure you do your own stimulation and you do own recording, because instead of depending on the anesthesiologist and they tell you, we don't know they are doing from hand or face area, which is more close to them. So you always try to do train up from the feet and yourself, and record that and document, and it's time locked with your signal.